All right, guys, welcome to this episode. First of all, I want to introduce my case. I'm creating a microservice project now, and I had two options for creating the inventory service using Python or Golang. Actually, I've used Python before, but I kept hearing that Go is better for building REST API. It's faster, lighter, and more efficient. But I can't just hear it like that and choose Go, right? I'm a practical person, so I need a real comparison to choose one of them. So I decided to create the inventory service using both languages, and I'll compare them side by side with startup time, memory usage, and development size. So in this video, we'll find out which one performs better. Let's get started. All right, guys, first round. We'll start with the startup time comparison. So make sure you open your Python project. You know, I also upload this project, Python service and Go service on my repository, and make sure you check it in the description below. And you know what? You can also create the inventory service with Python and Go by yourself, and you can check by yourself, you know. All right, so now open the terminal and turn on to Git bash. For the startup time and the Python, let's type like time Python main dot py like this, and we see. So it takes around 1.1 second to start, right? And what about Go? What about in Go service? So this is the inventory service built by Go, and let's turn on the Git bash, right? Not like the Python, we can type the time in the terminal like that. In Go, we can just do that. So I add this start time inside the main function here. So when we run the service, it will display in the log, the startup time in the log here. So it will bring the log for us. So let's see. All right, allow access. Right, so in the Go service, it takes around 9.5 milliseconds. So compared to the result of Python, we know, yes, that's totally a big distance, you know, big distance here. And we all know that at the start of time, Python is slower than Go, and Go is just, yes, millisecond, count as millisecond, but Python count as second. Right. So, maybe, you know, in the Python, I build the other service with the fast API. I know it's fast, you know, it's nice and others model and library, but it still take around 1 second to start, you know. So in this round, in this round goes in the guy who lists the first one, right? And maybe it's for anyone who don't know why Go is much faster than Python, and I can explain it a little bit, because Go compiles directly to machine code, so they know interpreter to load. And on the other hand, Python loads interpreter, passes Python files, initializes virtual machine, and yeah, loads modules and many things. And if you do more research, you can see that Go doesn't have garbage collectors, startup delays, in the same way Python runs time does. So that's why Python slower than Go at startup time. So we already compared the startup time, and Go is the winner. So we come to the next ground, right, snack ground memory, you say. All right, so when route to write memory, you say comparison. So I'll start with Go first. All right, let's open your Windows PowerShell. And to know the memory, you say we use tandlist command. So let's type follow my words. And okay, let me make sure. So I'll type tandlist. Right, find string inventory and press enter. All right, nothing shows. And you know what? Because I forgot to run my services. Sorry, but before we know how memory user it takes, we must run the service, you know. And I'm sorry for my mistake. And okay, all right, so you can see now, this is the memory it takes. So it's around 8.7 megabyte RAM. So we can call it around 8 to 9 megabyte RAM, okay? So what about Python's? And from the mistake I got in Go 7 versions, I'll run the Go 7 versions first, right? And let's type run it ubicoin, right, main app. So we'll run it on pork, whatever you want. All right, open another PowerShell and let's type tablist, find string Python, right. So what about it takes here? So it takes 48, right? 48. Around 48 megabyte RAM. So as you can see, when we run the Go version of this service, it uses about 8 to 9 megabyte RAM of memory and startup, right? But with the Python versions, using fast API, even though it's async and pretty fast for Python, the memory usage starts around 48 megabyte RAM, and it can vary depending on what it's running. You know, this might not a big deal at first when you're running 10 services, just a couple hundreds megabytes, but when you're running hundreds of services, memory usage start to eat into your cloud cost, server limits, and auto scaling behavior. And in Go, all thanks to your native compilation, no interpreter, no runtime package, and Python needs interpreter, standard lib, and fast API layer. That means more memory just to get started. If you're building a simple backend, Python is totally fine, but if you're targeting resource constrained system, high concurrency or massive scale, that's how memory footprint in Go can help you reduce infrastructure and improve system responsiveness. All right guys, so we're in the final round now. So we'll compare the development side, right? Actually, we'll compare the binary side and dependency chain of each services. So, because the command is too long, so I don't want to write line by line. So, yeah, I passed the, the command in the what we got here. So, in the Go PowerShell, we're using this command. All right. So let's copy and paste down like this, and press enter. We can see the binary sign here. So maybe you don't know this what is this command meaning, right? So this command tells you the extract sign of your Go app binary. So this is the binary sign of our Go app, right? Only 9.94 megabyte. And what about Python? In Python, all right. We copy this command, right? We copy this command and open another window PowerShell. And let's copy it. All right, So it takes 33, right? 33 megabyte. 34, I'm sorry. And this command, right? This command calculates the total size of all Python dependencies inside the virtual machine folder, you know, for short, you call it VM, right? Virtual machine folder. It also helps to help you to understand the footprint of your Python app. So this is the dependency chain, right? This is the just help you to count the binary size, and this is the dependency chain of your Python app, right? So, and maybe you wonder, you know, why I have to talk about binary size and dependency chain, and I know a lot of you maybe don't know about them, and you haven't heard about them. So I'll explain about it a little bit, right? Well, when we talk about deployability and performance at scale, binary size and dependencies aren't just numbers, you know, they directly affect how fast your service starts, how much it costs to run in production, how secure it is, and how easy it is to deploy. And, you know, all right. Go build into a single lightweight binary with no external runtime. So it's just very, very lightweight. It's just called about this. And why Python apps brings along an interpreter and a lot of packages. All right, you see a lot of packages here. And that's extra weight, you know, that extra weight might not matter in small project. It doesn't matter at all, you know. But when you're deploying hundreds of microservices or targeting serverless, edge or long memory environments, it really adds up, you know. So we all go through three rounds, right? And we all know after three rounds, Go is still the winner. And you know, after three rounds, we all know why they say Go is faster, lighter, and more efficient. And you know the reason why Python's slower than Go, right? Because the interpreter and a lot of packages in here, you know. And, you know, if anyone asks you why Go is fast and lightweight, you got to answer through three rounds and through this video, and you can prove that to them. You can prove that why Go is light and fast, right, and more efficient. You can prove them after three rounds, right, using this command. So I pass the command inside this, so you can follow this command inside the what we got file here. All right, so we're almost at the end of the video, and I just want to share a bit about my development experience from what I learned, what I like, and which language we should do, right? So this is my thoughts. Python is easier to start with, hands down. I know that you write something and it works really wonderful. Tons of library, tons of tutorial, but Go forces you to understand something like how server work, how routing works. It's more low level, but in good way. And you know what? Go doesn't have a lot of hidden stuff going on. Everything you write is clear and direct. You can see exactly what's happening here. In Python, a lot of things just work behind the scenes, like routing, database handling, or decorators. That's super nice when you're starting out because it saves time, but later it can get confusing. Harder to control when you need more performance or you want to optimize your code. That's harder. And tying to the framework, Python has huge ecosystem like Flask or the Django. They're very powerful, but they do a lot for you behind the scenes. In Go, you got options like Gorillamus or Fiber if you want more structure. but honestly, the built-in standard library is so solid that for simple services, you often don't need anything else. You can build a full REST API with just a few packages, and you know exactly how every part works. So this is the summary. Is Go better, right or not? So this is my answer. You know, it depends on what you're doing. If you want to build something fast and get it running, Python is great to choose. But if you need high performance and a lightweight backend, Go is a better option, especially for microservices. And for this project, Go makes more sense, so I choose Go to create the inventory service. You know what? I like how easy it was to deploy, and I didn't have to deal with pip, fang, or complex dependencies, but I still use Python for scripting and quick tools. You both and pick the right one for the job. That's what I want to refer in this video. If you're deciding between Go and Python for backend project, let's think about what matters to you, like speed, simplicity, performance, or speed of development and library support. And you know what? I hope this video will help you in your current and your future. And if you have any questions, you can drop your comment below. And yes, and through this video, you and me, we all know if we need something, we need to do something, and we confuse, as for you, you have to compare it, you know. You have to compare it side by side, and you know which one better for you with your options. All right. So, through this video, we know why Go is like faster, right? So, if you like this video, please like and subscribe to my channel. See you guys next time. Bye.